In this video, I'm going to show you how to find value stocks with just 10 clicks. For free, no account required. So what is value investing? Value investing is a strategy used by investors like Warren Buffett. Basically, it involves picking stocks that are undervalued based on the health of a company. The best way to explain value investing is by comparing it to growth investing. Value investing involves picking stocks that are undervalued currently, and growth investing emphasizes future prospects and may include picking overvalued stocks based on current health of companies. This video is about value investing, but if you want me to do a video about growth investing, let me know in the comments section. Also, you might want to hit subscribe and the bell so that you are first to know about my upcoming videos. Let's get started. First thing you're going to do is go to tradingview.com, and I will put the link in the description. Click launch chart. So this will show up here. In the bottom left, click stock screener. Then in the top right, click filters. The search box will open up, and just you can start typing price to. And here in price to earnings ratio, you're going to enter 5, so that'll be below 5. Price to book, you enter 1, which will make it below 1. Price to book FY, also below 1. And then you're going to erase that price 2 in the search box and type dividend. Oops, dividend, can't spell. Okay, and dividend yield, you're going to click on above and then enter 6. Close that out. So as you can see, the screener has found 20 matches. And at this point, you can filter some out or narrow them down further. But with 10 clicks, you get to 20 matches, which I would consider value stocks. Now, if you want to narrow this down further, what I would do is sort this column of price to earnings ratio such that it's from low to high, and pick stocks from a diverse set of industries, such as energy materials, finance, consumer durables, industrial services, consumer services, try to make a diverse portfolio. What you could also do is use TradingView's nice ratings feature, which is a technical analysis ratings. So if you go to the filters and you type rating, you can pick strong buy or buy, well, strong buy and buy, I'm sorry. And as you can see, that narrowed it down to 9 matches. And what that does is it gives you a technical analysis rating based on these oscillators, such as relative strength index, stochastics, commodity channel index, and so on. And also moving averages, which tells you if the trend is up or not. And yeah, so that would be a nice way to narrow it. So now you have value stocks, which have a decent technical analysis rating, and you can pick based on the price to earnings ratio and sectors to make sure you have a diverse set of stocks in a diverse sectors. So there you have it, how to find value stocks in just 10 clicks. Now, I want to go over the pros and cons of value investing so that you can decide whether this strategy will work for you. Let's start with the pros. Pro number one, if done correctly, value stocks are bought undervalued and sold later, way above their intrinsic value when that stock becomes popular. It's like buying an unpopular piece of art that later gains a ton of value when that piece of art becomes popular. It's not difficult to find evidence showing value investing outperforming growth investing over the long term. Pro number two, value investing, if done correctly, has less downside risk because you're buying the assets at a proper valuation, whereas overvalued equities have a chance of going down a lot because they're overvalued. Pro number three, value investing typically has higher dividend yields, and if you use those dividends to reinvest into your portfolio, you could potentially compound those dividends in with your gains. Okay, now for the cons. The number one con is poor diversification. Value investing typically leans heavy in certain sectors, such as finance, that have much stronger fundamentals than other sectors, such as technology. So, as you can see from the screener results, most of the results were in the finance sector. So, value investing could lean you into only a few sectors without much diversification. Con number two, patience is required for a long-term investment horizon. As I mentioned earlier, value stocks require decades of patience to appreciate in value. So if you're an investor that is impatient or have a short-term horizon, maybe value investing isn't right for you. Hey guys, I hope you liked the video. If it was informative, give me a thumbs up, leave a like, and I hope to see you next time. Con number two. Patience is required for value investing because investment horizons require decades of waiting and thinking and crying and comments on whether you liked it or not. You know, please help me. Please, I'm being held hostage right now. I actually saw a chart recently showing that, like, although value investing, like, doesn't beat growth investing in the near term, like 5-10 years, the amount they dropped due to this crash is actually... Oh, that's not a good thing. It should be less. Yeah, it should be less, but whatever.